Stoke City Football Club, a symbolic institution in a relatively deprived area. A place that is so important in the hearts of many within the city, and one which is known for its strong links within the local community. And it's here where the government-funded NCS project, David Cameron's brainchild, is taking place. The scheme is aimed at giving 16 and 17-year-olds vital skills whilst empowering them to give something back to the community while taking part in local projects. Graffiti, conservation, building renovations, and ones at the real heart of the community are just some of those projects the young people had to bid for, prepare and deliver. But before they set off for the Britannia Stadium, what did some of them hope to learn from the experience?
The experience of being out of home and to improve my CV, because it'll get me off the streets, like out the house, get me doing more physical activities, and will improve my team building activities and confidence.
But before the teenagers embarked on the local project, some team building activities were sought, working as a team seen as a vital principle underlining the delivery of these projects. Indeed, many of the teenagers taking part in the NCS programme hadn't even met each other before, yet were imminently going to be working very closely as a team.
Because there are some things you can do by yourself, but others you will need to call upon people, and whether you know them or don't know them, you need their help, so it's important to have teamwork with strangers and friends.
Team building being a necessary life skill as these teenagers embark on adult life. Midland Heart Sheltered Accommodation. A different generation and a completely different way of life for those living in this Stoke-based sanctuary. So it was refreshing to see a community project that was aimed at bridging the generational gap with a games tournament taking place, a one which states no age restrictions. Traditional board games activities which require a lot of thought have been left behind by many of today's generation in favour of less traditional PlayStations and Blackberries. So how will the teenagers find it against older and wiser wits?
It's about, I've tried for 22 years to have a game of chess a year. Unfortunately, no one else played, so I haven't played. So playing with Ryan was a new one-off for me. Unfortunately, he isn't bright enough to win, so he's a good lad, though.
Yeah. Not bright enough to win. I'll let you win. I'm sorry for you.
And also taking part was a famous face. Joyce, who has been an advocate for campaign Age Concern in the area of Staffordshire, knows better than anybody the importance of linking older and future generations in the community. And it was an opportunity she was not going to miss for the world.
Well, when I first heard about it, I thought, I'm such a nosy person and I like to know what's going on. And I must admit, I have learnt a lot. It's been great talking to the youngsters. And communication is such an important thing. I think to be able to talk to people that are much younger and older people, this is what is missing with so many people these days, just not able to talk to people. And it is vital, it is necessary. I've just loved it. It's just been an experience that I wouldn't have missed for anything. And I'm hoping that people will go away and say, it's a different look, different outlook on shared accommodation, because people are just not sitting around doing nothing. We're wanting to do something. And a lot of people have got a very lot of interesting things to talk about.
But from my point of view, right, the age I am, right, it was almost a revelation, right, because we've lived in here for 22 years, so consequently we've been with what you call old people for that length of time, right? So conversations have virtually been nil. The fact is I could sit down with a young mind and write, right? It was almost like a revelation. I got the opportunity to have a conversation with someone, a meaningful conversation. Yeah,
and you also notice while playing the game of chess that the older generation take the time with stuff, as us younger generations just rush into everything. Because during the game of chess, I was making all the quick moves and then waiting for my move again without thinking.
Well, was it enough to win that, was it?
It was nearly enough.
Very nearly.
Is there going to be a rematch between you two, do you think?
No, I'm not playing him again. No, I've no sworn then. I'm not.
No,
I'm not taking that chance.
I'd like to think that we keep in touch. I really would, because I've so enjoyed this. You know, if it's only every now and again, it would be really nice to have a little meeting here and check up on how much further you've gone and perhaps what we've done, you know, what we've perhaps learnt from it. It's made me remember things that I have forgotten, to be perfectly honest. Yes.
And so to the Britannia Stadium. Nets were being put up a few weeks before the season started, and it seemed an empty place without football. But that didn't stop youngsters taking part in the graffiti project, one which is aimed at tapping into the artistic talents of all those involved. But more importantly, it was giving many the unique chance to really leave a mark in the community and stamp their legacy in a place so important to the residents in Stoke. And for future generations in the Potteries.
We made it like a start on yesterday, like going over all the walls in white, ready for today so we can put the logos and stuff on the walls. So like, we've made like a lot more people like from different areas, and we've like got like made friends with them, got along with them. Like when we've been working with them on the designs and stuff.
Teamwork.
It's like, it's going to look really good on the CVs and that, and obviously like when we go for a job they'll look at it. And they'll maybe like ask us about it, and then we can tell them the skills we've learned and stuff when we did the project.
They did a quick practice session for about an hour or so a couple of weeks ago, and they've just come and painted, and they've obviously listened. You can see the way they painted that, they've listened, and they've taught themselves, really, to be fair. So it opens different opportunities. If I wasn't artistic, I did struggle at school doing everything else, to be honest, but the art sort of got me through, got me to different avenues. You can learn basic skills. It's the same as everything. The more you practice, the better you get.
I painted this street badge and the other street badge so I can like, tell my friends and family that I've done it. Because I have a season ticket in the family stand, and my mates have season tickets down here. They can come and see it for generations, for ages, like for a few years.
We've got youngsters in the group who will be going on to do A-levels, we've got youngsters who will be looking for different kinds of trades, and this is giving them a chance to work together and do something practical in their community, but it does give them some useful skills that they'll find helpful later in life. The hall is local to Stoke City, it's part of Stoke Parish, so you know we're glad to be doing it for the local area really, and the club gets used by all sorts of groups, by the brownies and the guides and pensioners for bingo and taekwondo for a class and so on. So yeah, it's a good facility for the community. Yeah, and hopefully they'll go on to volunteer and be good community members later.
And it's not just man-made projects, but also the environment, which is seen as a vital part of the NCS theme.
They've been helping us with the site, with the management of the site. So they've been clearing some areas. We've got a lot of Himalayan balsam, which takes over. So we've been clearing some of the Himalayan balsam, giving the other plants a chance to grow up, encourage a lot of wildlife, a lot of insects. And they've also been doing some coppicing for us, so just tending to the woodland, clearing the litter as well, just making it even better for the families and children that visit.
And we've just been digging up some plants here to make the path a lot bigger. To helping out the community and stuff like that. Like helping, because I want to be in the armed forces, just like to help giving a helping hand, so this might give a little if back.
We're going to do a survey of the animals in the different habitats. So we've got woodland areas, we've got meadow land, we've also got around the lake, so we'll do some freshwater surveys as well. So hopefully we'll get a good count, take some photos, and then just show off what wildlife we've got here.
And what's been gained from the project is summed up perfectly by Jason.
Helps build confidence, make new friends, do things you've never done before, develop skills that you probably thought that you wouldn't have, and just get confident and make yourself stronger in what you think you can do. So, if there's things you haven't done, Obviously it gives you opportunities to try, and if obviously you don't park it, then you don't have to do it again. I think it's build CV, obviously make your CV look good, feel like just make yourself employable, and make yourself a better person.
And it's clear what has been achieved by these teenagers is no doubt something they wouldn't have had the chance to embark on thanks to the NCS project and Stoke City Football Club. And for that, the future is certainly looking bright.